So a paleontologist is a scientist who uses fossils to reconstruct past lives, using them to think about what the environments were like and also to think about how those different animals evolved over time.
So paleontology isn't just dinosaurs, it includes all fossils. So that could be shellfish that lived at the bottom of the sea, it could be snails that lived on land, it could be plants as well. So paleontology is a study of fossils, not just dinosaurs.
So no, not just dinosaurs. Paleontologists will study an array of animals, plants, even bacteria in some cases. So we work on insects, dinosaurs, fish, the whole environment.
A paleontologist is somebody who works to recover, document and research fossils and evidence of the ancient life that's existed on Earth and the story of how life on Earth has developed over time. It could be an amateur perspective. I think lots of amateur fossil hunters are very, very skilled and very knowledgeable, and they're certainly paleontologists as well. Or it could be in terms of things like academic research. There are lots of scientists who work actively to research and investigate the history of life on Earth as well. So they can cover both of those terms.
By far the best part of being a paleontologist is actually being here, being out on a coastline setting, actually finding these fossils. They've been preserved for a lot of the time, hundreds of millions of years, and knowing you're the first person to find that, pick that up and discover that is a really, really exciting thing.
I like the field work, so I like getting out on beaches or out in the desert or, you know, wherever we need to go. So it can be nice, lots of travel and excavation is always good.
The opportunity to travel all around the world to see really, really cool fossils that no one else has studied or no one else has seen before. I love being outdoors, I love field work, so I love being able to do that. And I also meet a whole bunch of interesting people in my job.
The elements I've enjoyed the most is when I've come down the beach with my fellow sort of fossil collectors and we've stumbled upon things, and it's just the general discussion about the rocks and what we found and learning from each other. And I've had a few moments like that where I've just really appreciated the time. It's been really, really nice.
The best part of the job for me, I think, is where we run the tours. That we've had loads of children who specifically who are very, very knowledgeable about dinosaurs, about paleontology, and they're really passionate about it. I was like that as a child. And there's been loads of times where kids have found things and you see the enthusiasm in their face. You see them gain a passion for the natural world and for natural history that might have been sparked by that moment.
I think the absolute best thing about being a paleontologist is being that first person who ever sees a fossil. So the fossils have been in the ground for millions of years, and if you find it, you're literally the first human being ever to see that object. And that element of discovery is probably the funnest part for me.
By far, my favourite moment was when I was fossil hunting just along this coastline, actually. I was with Theo, who's one of our other paleontologists, and we're just walking along, and just sticking out of the water was a perfect Ice Age horse skull that was around 100,000 years old, and it was just lying there like somebody just placed it there. And to see a complete skull, it's not typically the sort of thing you see on the beach, but to have that just sticking out perfect was a really, really amazing moment.
So I've been lucky enough to name a number of dinosaurs from all around the world. So for example, I was involved in naming a little dinosaur from Japan called Albilophosaurus, which is an early relative of later things like Triceratops. And also from the earliest dinosaurs, I named an animal called Nyasasaurus, which is in our collections at the museum, which is probably the earliest dinosaur that we know about, coming from about 240 million years ago.
One of my most memorable moments in my career has been to dig up dinosaurs and study dinosaurs in Morocco, which has been really amazing. And to find a dinosaur and a dinosaur specimen that nobody else has ever seen before, but also is just totally unlike anything that we've ever seen.
So I like it because it's a world untouched by man. So we're looking at environments that we've had no interaction with, so we can really see how the world ticks. I always think if we can't understand the past, it makes interpreting the future very difficult.
I think paleontology is important because it tells a story of how life on Earth has developed. For me, there's nothing more fascinating than the wildlife that we have on the planet today, our biodiversity, and to learn the story that took place for that to develop, all the drama involved with it, the evolution, the extinction. Paleontology tells us about every single thing that's happened to us previously and that's happened to life on Earth. So I think to know what's going to happen in the future, we have to know what's happened in the past. And paleontology gives us that context to understand what we see around us today.
So paleontology is really important for two reasons. First of all, it establishes our place in the tree of life. So we only really know about many of the plants and animals that have ever existed thanks to the fossil record. And by knowing about them, we can build ever more accurate trees of our own evolutionary history and how we got here to be here today. Not just humans, but also all the other animals and plants that we see around us. The other reason it's really important is it tells us about what life was like in the past and how those different kinds of animal groups and plant groups have changed in response to environmental change. So for example, we currently live at a time of unprecedented environmental change, which is caused largely by human activity, but some of those changes are similar to natural changes that occurred in the past. And by studying those past changes, we might get some better idea of how living ecosystems might respond to those changes now.
I think paleontology has never been more important than it is today. And that's because if we want to understand how, for example, species ranges are going to change on a warming Earth that we're seeing today, then we can't just look at today's time slice. We need to look at times in the past when we see similar rates of warming and see how animals responded. And we can only do that by looking at the fossil record. We can't do that today. So paleontology is really, really critical if we hope to understand how the world's going to change in the light of climate change.
Thanks for watching. If you're enjoying this, then let us know in the comments below and keep watching for more from this series. As always, make sure you subscribe to our channel to keep up to date with the latest fascinating content from the Natural History Museum.